And we're here at the International Energy Forum, and joining me now is Leila Benali from Apicorp. Leila, thank you so much. You were talking about investments, particularly when we look here at this day, the IEF-EU Energy Day, really looking at what investments need to be made. Talk to us a bit more about that.
Yeah, I mean, it's well, thank you very much, Etni, for the introduction. We are here at the building of the IEF. It's a historic building, and the IEF, may I remind you, we congratulate them for the 20th anniversary, and that's something that is quite important in the world where at the beginning it started between consumers and producers, and that dialogue and cooperation was quite key. Now today we are in that room where we are looking into the importance of investments as well. So we're bringing investors into the table. And that's, I think, quite key, because we need to ensure that the investments are flowing in the right direction and following the policies that were devised by different countries. So that's why I think it's quite important to have this dialogue today between the EU, the European Union, which has been quite progressive in issues around climate change, and the MENA and GCC region, where you see a lot of renewable technology being penetrating, actually, the energy mix.
And also, of course, it's all part of the energy transition. And when we look at that energy transition, there's no, there's no definite date on it. It's a process. It will take time. So really, it's also about making sure the investment is there, probably still in conventional fuel and in renewables as well.
I think you raise a great point, Etni, because all these players are having different time frames, different horizons. You have the long-term investors that are looking into 2040, 2050 horizons. The politicians are having different time horizons, and you have some investors that are looking into the next 5 years. And these technologies have different time spans. So it's quite important, again, to bring all these people together and look at the investments that are needed for the energy transition, looking around the same sort of time frame. So I think this is the key challenge that the energy industry as a whole is looking at. Bear in mind, and that's something that was being mentioned today in the discussions, that 41% only of emissions are coming from the energy sector. We'll still need to abate emissions in the non-energy sector as well.
So the dialogue actually needs to move even beyond this, and really I think the understanding of people too needs to perhaps maybe put a little less pressure on the energy market, because it's probably one of the most essential markets, and it will take a while until we can actually find the new type of energy for everybody.
I think the solutions will come from the energy sector, because this is where you have champions, investors, and also investments coming in. The non-energy sector has to be really much taken into account. So we still are looking into hard to abate sectors, typically in the heavy industries, but also, and that's another number that was mentioned today, 70% of emissions are coming from non-G20 countries. So I also congratulate Saudi Arabia for hosting the G20 meeting this year, and that's provide a global arena to the kingdom to have this sort of global discussions, because at the end of the day, it's a global issue that will require global solutions.
Now, here at the International Energy Forum, a global organization, how important do you find this organization, 20 years old and looking ahead to perhaps its continued relevance and its importance in the years to come?
I think the transformation of the IEF has been fascinating over the last 20 years, and the fact that we are having the 10th anniversary tomorrow of the OPEC-IEA-IEF dialogue is also telling us how this debate between producers and consumers has evolved beyond just the dialogue between these two groups, I would say, of countries and players, into a more integrated discussion between all the different players that are involved, and not only producers and consumers, but also investors and activists and NGOs and politicians. So we have to integrate all these people together to come up with the right solutions that are important come up with the right solutions for a successful energy transition.